For our hot copy today, this Friday morning, creating a comb for inspiration and not as a showcase. These are the guiding principles for creative entrepreneur Stephanie Kinley Gonzalez as she shares her ideas in her first book, Embracing Natural Design. This is published by Rizzoli, no less. Stephanie is also a Capamilia. She hosts a show on Metro Channel. She joins us this morning. Stephanie, good morning to you.
Hi, Karen. Good morning. Thank you for having me today.
All right. Now, this book, this book published by Rizzoli, this coffee table book, is no small feat. Now, tell us about this. How did this happen?
Thank you, Karen. You know, it all started when I decided to chronicle some of my design work. And I just thought it would be a great reference for me to look back at, share my inspirations and the experiences I've had, whether it be personal design or through our company, Philox. And the thought of turning it into a first draft of a book occurred, and I reached out to some friends in the local publishing industry, and they were very encouraging. And after, you know, I received that encouragement, I thought, okay, let me send out a first deck to Rizzoli, because they were my dream publisher. And serendipitously, they came back to me very positively, and they wanted to support my book. And that's when I realized, okay, this project is ripe to pursue.
What's amazing with this is you are bringing Filipino design to the forefront internationally. You know, the world knows about other Asian designs, but Filipino design needs more exposure. So how did you put it together in this book, and why was that the focus? Because you also have your African home in the book.
That's right, Karen. So I guess when I was putting together the concept of the book, I realized that throughout all my work, there was really a common thread, and that common thread was natural, bringing nature in and natural design. And that's something that we see very much in the Philippines, because the nature that we have here is just tremendous, the craftsmanship as well. And so throughout the book, that's really a concept that I try to develop, whether it's by bringing some greenery in home or encouraging different ways to layer natural raw materials, or simply by supporting local, making more conscious design decisions that support local smaller communities. And this is how, throughout the stories of the book, which are quite personal to me, I try to push this message forward. There is a part of the book, Karen, at the end where I highlight creatives and tastemakers who have moved me and inspired me. And this is a part that I really like, because I share different stories and their design philosophies as well.
It's quite a bold step, considering first, this is Rizzoli, and one would think you'd have to be internationally famous, right, for Rizzoli to publish a coffee table book of you. And yet you were able to achieve that. What do you think attracted Rizzoli to your presentation or your proposal?
Well, you know, it was a very visual concept initially. So I really wanted to create striking images. And I worked with some really amazing photographers who lent me their talent. And we really like collaborated and had this creative direction that was quite succinct. And I think the photography can speak for itself. Yeah. And I think the idea of having the Philippines as a spotlight, I don't think you see that often in Rizzoli books. That's definitely one of the few things that my editor highlighted in the beginning, saying, you know, the Philippines is something we don't know much about. And so this right away caught our attention. And I was so happy to shine a bit of spotlight to our country.
What is the world missing with Filipino design?
What do you mean, Karen?
What aren't they seeing? I mean, clearly we can have Filipino design or Philippine design at the forefront all over the world.
Well, for me, it's really, we're known to be good manufacturers because we have such skilled labor. But but for being known for design itself, I think is something that we need to push forward, that we have creatives as well. It's not just the workforce behind it that follows trends from abroad, but that we can also initiate these trends and these designs. I think that's something that we can push forward even more.
Yeah. In your book, you feature homes, well, your home in Manila, and also your home in Africa, and I think some other homes, right, that yes. show natural design. But what similarities are you seeing with African and Filipino design? Because your African home is highlighted in the book as well.
Yes, I see a lot of bringing the outdoors in. You know that concept of lanai living? We are surrounded by such beautiful surroundings both here and in South Africa that you need to take advantage of that, I think. And you know, having these kind of bright open spaces and bringing the outside in is a concept that I saw throughout most of the homes that I featured.
Mm-hmm. You've been actually going all over. You are leaving for New York to plug tonight. The book. Yeah, you're leaving for New York tonight. And I saw that you also did, I think, a book signing in South Africa as well. How are they receiving it, you know, when here you are, you're a first-time author, you're from the Philippines, this is a major coffee table book. How are they receiving it? What do they say when they meet you and they see the book?
I was so pleasantly surprised. I was in South Africa over Easter, and an interior design store who actually imports as well pieces from the Philippines reached out to me to host it, and I was excited about it. And I met so many people in the design industry. I love their enthusiasm. They were so welcoming and gracious towards me, and it was just such a great opportunity for me just to share. To share ideas, to communicate with other creatives, but in South Africa, and trying to share, the similarities that we have with the Philippines and the design aesthetic there.
All right.
I'm now, very grateful for that.
Yeah. Stephanie, of course, you are the president of Philips, and Philips has it's an old brand, an institutional brand in furniture making, but you and your sister have also reinvigorated Philips, so to speak. How can we take a brand like Philips all over the world, considering that, you know, you have Italian brands that are well known, French brands that are well-known? How do we penetrate this market, Steph?
You know, it's really all about keeping our authenticity and not forgetting that we are proudly Filipino. I feel like that's always been at the heart of our company, championing conscious Filipino craft. And that conscious Filipino craft can be global, right? So it's not forgetting that identity, really leveraging on that and just being dynamic. I think that competition is healthy. Learning from these international brands is, of course, it's wonderful to try to step it up and take it to the next level. But as I said, just really maintaining that idea of who we are and that identity. And pushing that forward even more.
Okay. Now, you wear many hats. You are also, I have to say, a host in Metro Channel. You co-host a show. And I wanted to ask you, are you still doing that show?
So I didn't shoot Metro Home Season 3. My sister thankfully stepped in on my behalf because I was very pregnant at the time. Yeah. But it's been a wonderful experience, hosting Metro Home. It's something that really also came about as a surprise, but it was an opportunity that I seized, and I feel like it was a great learning experience for me, and hopefully we can do more in the near future.
Where did the love for homes start? Clearly your parents have owned Philips, but it's all over. You represent it, you breathe it, you live it. When did this begin?
Well, I really witnessed my parents' entrepreneurial spirit growing up. They were a young couple that really strived for Philox, for their business, and Jessica and I with accompany them in the, you know, whether it be on the factory floor with my dad or in retail when my mom was developing the showrooms. And I think that's where I kind of had a feel for retail, but when and manufacturing, but when I went abroad and I lived in these amazing cities, I had the opportunity to live in New York and Paris for school, I really appreciated design and I saw it in a completely different light. And so coming back here, I thought this is something I really want to pursue, but focus on something purely Filipino. And that's something that's been my purpose since then.
Yeah, Stephanie, how would you define modern Filipino design?
I think it's really hard to define. I feel that when you say Filipino, a lot of the times people think it's rustic and native, but you can translate this modern Filipino aesthetic into something that's so contemporary and global. For instance, Karen, we recently were tasked to be the local design consultants of Louis Vuitton Manila. My sister and I helped them develop this Filipino design story, and we collaborated with artisans, very simple, humble products, to artisans that were, you know, a little bit more edgy and global already, but Filipino, all Filipino. And we put together this very, very interesting and beautiful design story that was so authentically Filipino. But Karen, when you enter the store, you feel like you are in a Louis Vuitton global store, you know, and yet you'll see the lighting fixture in the hot zone. It's made with a very simple rattan design light, but in that setting, it is highlighted. So in a way, you have some native, but you have, you know, you can convert these more rustic and traditional materials into designs that are really a lot more innovative. And that's something that I feel like we can continue working on and developing. Yeah.
Do we have enough raw materials, Stephanie? I mean, when you open your book, it's very rich. So my question is, can we really get them in the Philippines?
There are amazing resources, and something, it's a continuous learning process for me and for Jessica, always trying to see what we can do with these materials. Obviously, naturally, in our case, we also look at whether it's a material that's sustainable. That's a very important criteria for us. And of course, that limits sometimes the range, but you can see that overall, the direction of design and this industry is being a lot more aware about our, you know, environmental footprint. And so it's, I'm hoping that in the near future, even more products will come about.
Yeah. All right. Now, you talked about sustainability. The other hat that you wear is you are a member of the Next Generation Council of WWF Philippines. You're also an ambassador for WWF.
Yes. Yes, I am.
Yeah. Okay. Let's talk about that, because you're quite passionate about your work with WWF.
Yes, I've, luckily been involved with WWF for a few years now, and with a group of like-minded individuals, we spearheaded this campaign called Ayoko ng Plastic, and it was really for the awareness of single-use plastic, and just finding ways on how people can address this. Mm-hmm. I don't think many know, but in 1 week, the average human being consumes one credit card of plastic, of microplastics, every week. And, you know, this data is quite frightening. The Philippines is actually the third largest polluter of single-use plastics globally. And so my involvement there is really just to try to help with awareness, just to spearhead, you know, these campaigns, involve the youth as well, because I think that to make change, you need to get the youth involved, and you need to educate. You need to educate people about the situation.
So does this mean, Stephanie, that plastic, any form of plastic, is not in any of the designs of Philux, or is not in any part of the book?
No, not at all. Plastic is not evil. That's not what I'm trying to say. But I think single-use plastic is something that we need to be aware of. So something we've done, for instance, in Philux, because sustainability is really a core value, we've partnered with Green Ants, which is a social enterprise I discovered a couple of years back. And I was very interested to learn that they upcycle waste, and specifically single-use plastic waste. So over the past few years, we've partnered with them and have managed to upcycle about 1,500 kilos of our single-use plastic waste. And what they do is they shred it and they convert it into viable construction materials to build schools or for infrastructure. Yeah. And so that's not the solution, but it's certainly one way to address the waste problem. Mm-hmm. And the second part of our partnership with Green Ants is something a little bit more interesting and more related to the question you had just asked. It's about using innovative solutions to upcycle and create raw materials from your waste. So okay. What we're trying to do now is work with Green Ants to develop a chair glider, you know, a very simple chair glider, the ones you put under your dining chairs, from our retrieved single-use plastic waste. Mm. And so that way you can reintegrate the product in your production line, and that really helps develop this idea of a circular economy model.
Okay, a while ago you said that the Philippines is known for manufacturing, right? But yes. Clearly you are pushing the Filipino brand. That's one thing that you're pushing for. Is that a challenge abroad?
No, I definitely think it's a challenge, but it's one that, you know, that will be, I think it's one that we should pursue, because globally, I feel that the markets are ready to appreciate something, to appreciate a brand that's not just Italian or American. Mm-hmm. And, the quality can speak for itself of our products and other Filipino products, and the stories behind them, I think, is also something you want to highlight.
Yeah. What did you enjoy most about making this coffee table book? And how long did it take you, Steph?
Gosh, it took me all of the pandemic. Funnily enough, Karen, I'm meeting my editor and my publisher for the first time in New York because we did everything through Zoom. But my favorite part was really the creative side of the book. I love developing the creative direction, working with the photographers. That's a side that I really enjoyed. I also really enjoyed writing it, because it's such a personal, it's so close to my heart. You know, a lot of the stories were so personal from my experiences, and it was...
Your parents are actually in the book. We should say that. You talk about your history. Yeah, you talk about your family history.
Yes, because many people don't know this, but my dad was actually born in the Congo, and that's where my affinity for Africa really started. You know, hearing about all his wild adventures during his youth.
Yeah. You know, I'm curious, you said it's the first time you'll be meeting the publisher. The person who did the foreword for your book is India Hicks, and she's quite famous in the design community, in the interior design community worldwide. How did that happen? Are you friends?
You know, I reached out to her online. That's really how things happen nowadays. And she's someone who I've looked up to for many years for her very, you know, kind of like effortless chic and barefoot luxury kind of aesthetic. I also love that she's a philanthropist, and we both have this affinity for nature, this love for nature, and how she just picked up her family and created roots in the Bahamas and And I thought that was something, you know, incredible and very courageous. So I reached out to her and I explained to her my story and what I wanted to, you know, what I wanted to share with my readers through this book. And she was very encouraging. I'm very grateful to have her support and endorsement.
All right. Now, I want to congratulate you, Stephanie, for this. And I guess, where are you envisioning this to go?
Well, right now, I just really want to...
Will this be for sale, for example, in New York?
It will, absolutely. It's in all the bookstore, all the major bookstores where you find fine books, fine coffee table books. You'll have it on Amazon as well. And here in the Philippines, it's available on my website, stephaniekinleygonzalez.com, and across all the Philux showrooms.
All right. Congratulations to you, Stephanie, and good luck with your trip tonight.
Thank you for your support, Karen. I truly appreciate it.